Hey there, thanks for watching with Wendy. This tutorial will show you how to make what I call an everything clutch. There's a few things that are pretty consistent whenever you switch bags or backpacks. You want to bring with you a lip balm, a gum, your money. So I decided to make this clutch that would actually fit all the things that I need when I'm switching between bags, and it makes being on the go a lot easier. I'll just show you guys what's inside. This is how it looks from the front. It's just got this flap that's held together by the button. That I just sewed on the sewing machine, and then I sewed that square onto this clutch. So it wasn't that hard. When you open it up, on the inside, there's all the stuff I have. So this is Burt's Bees, my lip balm. This is cuticle oil for when I have dry fingers. Here's where I keep some loose coins, like a monkey. Over here, I've got my gum. I have a little mirror that I carry. There's my wallet that's got my cards and my coupons and all that stuff. And then this is some other stuff I carry on, which is like hand wipes. You never know. So that's what fits inside here. When I sewed this, I purposely made it so that it would fit all the stuff that I actually carry around all the time, and that's why I like it so much. To make your own, you just need about 0.3 meters of fabric. I suggest choosing a firmer fabric if you can, something that maybe is meant for pants or for hats. And you're definitely gonna need some fusible interfacing just to give it a little more structure. In terms of time, this is a really fast project. You should be able to finish it in about half an hour. If you like this tutorial, make sure you subscribe to see more, and I hope you guys have a great day. Bye. Take your sheet of fabric and fold it in half. Cut out a piece that's around 20 centimeters in width. Then cut the piece down so it's about 30 centimeters long. Take that strip of fabric and iron it flat. Lay down some fusible interfacing that's cut to the same size and iron them together. The firmer you want the final product, the more interfacing you should use. Fold the whole thing in half and iron it flat. Seal off the three raw edges using a zigzag stitch or using a serger. Fold one flap over so that it's big enough to hold all of your essentials, and we're going to sew along the top and bottom edge. This stitch needs to be really secure, so make sure you go back and forth a couple of times at the base and at the end of the flap. Flip the flap inside out and push outwards on the corners to make sure they're nice and straight. Fold in the edges on the top flap and sew these in place as well. Because I like the serger finish, I decided to leave that edge undone. Put all your essentials inside the clutch to decide where the fastener needs to go. Here you can use any kind of attachment, Velcro, zipper, buckle, button. I decided to use these fasteners because they're a little faster to access than buttons. Put the thread through the spot where you would like the fastener to go, and then slip the fastener over the thread. Go in and out of all the loops until it's secure. Whenever you put the needle through, double check that no thread has appeared on the other side. You want to make sure that all of this stays on the inside so no one can see it. Here's a close-up so you can see how I did it, although when it comes to these fasteners, there's really no technical way to get it done. When you've made it all the way around, slip the needle through a small piece of fabric. To finish it off, wrap the thread around the needle two times, then hold the needle down firmly at the base of the thread and pull it outward so that the knot is really close to the fabric. Do this two times and your knot should stay pretty secure. Check out my tutorial on how to make an infinity scarf and feel free to share this with a friend. See you next time!